What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my laboratory. Safety is number one priority. And today I'm going to teach you how to float the depends. So let's say you were on a boat and boat flipped over and sunk, and all you have is just your pants, and you're stuck in the lake and you're super tired, you cannot swim no more. You gotta keep swimming somehow, right? So you don't drown. Well, instead of keep tiring yourself, use this hand motion to keep yourself afloat. We're going to use pants to keep ourselves afloat. So first of all, I'm gonna take off the pants. Don't worry though, I have swimming trunks right under my pants. So we got the end of the pants right here. We're gonna just make a simple knot so it doesn't untie. You know, using my legs to float, I'm kinda getting tired already, and if I'm like in the middle of a giant lake or even in the ocean on the bay, sometimes you gotta swim for like 30 minutes, 40 minutes. You gotta swim for like almost 2 hours sometimes. If it's a big lake, you probably get exhausted. So it's easier to just take a break and float and slowly swim. So these pants will help you. We're gonna put it over our necks like this. So then you see I got a zipper side up. It need to be zipped up all the way. Then I'm gonna open the pants and use the heated water to get oxygen inside of the pants. Like this, just to keep your pants moist. And if you run out of air again, just grab some air like this and hold it, put it together and give some pants the moist, so they don't go away. Whew, and you're gonna stay floating. You see, I can just kick my legs, use my legs to keep swimming, keep the pants moist, and that way I'm using very, very low energy and using like very little bit of energy using my legs to keep swimming. Pretty awesome, right? Once again, if the air goes away, just get a few scoops of oxygen, put the pants together again, keep it moist, and you can swim. You know what? I love this hack. This is the best survival hack I ever seen. Oh wow. If you put this pants between your ankles and close these legs together, that's even easier. Look, I'm lifting my hands up and I'm floating. How cool is that? But keep your pants moist though, because if you're not, the oxygen will come out. So this is definitely an amazing survival hack. Look at that. I'm like completely relaxed. Honestly, I can float for like this for hours. And today I'm gonna show you how to power up this kind of flashlight with a 6-volt battery. You see, it's not gonna fit no way into this flashlight. Well, with this hack, I'm gonna teach you how to do it. Well, let's get to it. So you got one of those big flashlights that runs on these three big batteries. And let's say they are dead. And what are you gonna do? All you have is one of these batteries and a flashlight, and these batteries are dead. How can you use this to power up this flashlight? Simply, all we have to do is open it. And let's see what's inside of these batteries. Kids, do not try this at home. So if we open it, look what we find. We find this giant batteries inside of it. Now we're gonna take them apart. And all we need is put two of them. This is the bottom, this is the top. Two of them in there. And screw this top on. And let's see if it's gonna turn on. Guess what? And it works perfectly. So you can substitute this battery, just two of this instead of three of this. And in survival situation, if you need to power up flashlight and you only have one of these batteries, you actually have four of these batteries. And it only takes 2 bottles for this flashlight. Super awesome, huh?
Have you ever bought, built yourself furniture? I know a lot of you probably say yes. So, you know how every time you buy, build yourself furniture, it comes with this Allen wrenches, with those boxes of furniture, at least one or two for sure. And after we build like a little bench or a little table, we just stick it in a jar because it just repeats of the Allen wrenches. So we have lots of Allen wrenches and barely use them because they are, most of them are same size. All you will need 3 or 4 similar size Allen wrenches, and we're going to make a little grill or a stove out of it, or a pot stand, whatever you want to call it. So let's see how we're going to set it up. What we will need to find is 3 same size Allen wrenches. There you go, boom, we got ourselves 3 similar sizes of Allen wrenches. If you like using alcohol stove or little stoves like that, what I would like to do is just get a rock, put it in the dirt a little bit. Boom, this is gonna be my platform for alcohol stuff. But if I wanna cook with a big pot, this is not very sturdy. You see it's kind of wobbles around, especially if it's full with water. It's not the best. So this is why we will need this Allen wrenches. What we're gonna do, just put it like this into the ground. 1, 2, and 3 on this side. There you go. And now when we put a pot on it, it actually sits really steady. Maybe this one a little bit deeper. Just level it so it's all about same size. And boom. If you want to have even more durability and less wobble, just set 4 of this. Like that. On the same level. And there you go. Also, you can use same trick with the small campfire. Space them out close to each other. Let's see how big is the pot. So maybe second one right here, third one here, and a fourth one right here. Something like that. Boom. And then we're going to put our pot right here. Of course, this is, since we don't have a huge pot to boil water with, we probably don't even need a huge stick, just the smaller ones. Maybe this one's gonna be the biggest. And boom, look at that fire. Now I can put my pot right over it and no problem. It stands really, really steady. We should add water in here and see how fast we can boil water. And look at that, we have a perfect cook stove. And once the smaller sticks burn off, I can add on the bigger ones like this. And of course, you don't want to choke it out. Maybe add some smaller sticks at the same time. Kind of mix it up. So look how well it's boiling. Amazing. Now it's a lot easier to take it off and put it back on. Look how well it is. Today we're going to fill up air mattress with the garbage bag. Let's check this out. I gotta fill up this big air mattress. I do not have an air pump for that. What we can do is grab a garbage can and get to the corner and cut off a piece like that. Boom. You see, without air pump, it will take me 30 minutes and I will probably pass out of breath blowing up my mattress with my mouth. So we got a hole like this. You can even rip it open if you want to. Also, actually, we will need a rubber band. Grab it like that. Put it, make sure you open it, put it over the nozzle, and then we're gonna put a rubber band on it. What we're going to do is just go like this a couple times and then close it. And then put all the air inside of the bag. Start this again. You know what? This bag might be a little bit too big and too heavy. So actually, I'm going to get a smaller garbage bag. Okay, once again, I got here a hole on the side of the bag. Then I'm gonna get pretty durable rubber band and put it over the hole like this. Then I'm gonna get that bag and a rubber band and put it right on top of this nozzle. That's it. We're going to close it a little bit and just blow on it. You see how much air we blew with one blow, because we're not really blowing it like this. It will take you very long. But you see, let me get all the air out. But if you kind of close the entrance a little bit
and just blow it from far away. Let's see what happens. Look, two breaths, full garbage can of air. And now we can just use our body to transfer all the air into the air mattress. If you don't want to breathe into it, it's okay. You can just catch the air and push it in. Catch the air and push it in. You see how much air we already filled up? You know, with just the mouth, it will take me forever to fill it up. You know what? It works with a small bag. Let me try to do this with the big bag again, and probably will be a lot faster with the big bag. You know, with a bigger bag, you can just go like this without even blowing. And then just push it all the air in. That's a lot of air. Look at this. The full garbage bag of air. Wow, look at this, how much air. All at once. And with the bigger bag, you don't even have to blow. All I have to do is just go like this, get some air towards the end, and then push some air inside of the air mattress. This is awesome. This is the best way. Open it again. Catch air. Whoa, that's like the most air. Wow, I can see air mattress blowing up so fast. Whew. Okay, few more of these bags and it's done. Look at that. You don't want to blow air too fast because the rubber bands will pop out. I love this trick or life hack, whatever you want to call it. You know what? There's plenty of times where I had air mattress and I did not have any pump, or my batteries have died for the pump. So I'm definitely going to be using this next time.
And today I'm going to show you a pretty cool trick, chopping wood with the axe. In case all you have is an axe to split wood, I'm going to show you the easiest way to split the wood with an axe. Let's check this out. Lay this one down like this. Make sure it doesn't roll. Pretty steady. Then grab an axe and go. Boom! Did you see that? And then in two pieces right here. Done. Put this one aside. Now this one. Easy. So here's a few reasons why I don't split wood vertical. First of all, if you're gonna try to split it on a dirt, you're gonna keep hitting it and driving into the dirt, the log, so it's gonna take a lot longer to split the log and a lot more energy. So that's why you need to find a bigger log to set your smaller logs on top of it. But if they cut sideways, sometimes you're gonna have trouble setting them up, you see? You gotta figure it out so they would stand. And you see it's all sideways, so if you hit it, sometimes it will just fall sideways. It's not very comfortable, it's annoying. When I split wood this way, let's say I missed, and it's gonna go fly this way. So I gotta catch the axe so it doesn't fly into my leg, this side or that side. So I'm gonna lose a lot of energy catching the axe if I miss. And also, when I do split the piece of wood, let's see, split it, it just gets stuck really, really hard, and it's annoying to take it out. You gotta reposition the log and hit it again. And just keep getting stuck. So you gotta reposition the log, take it out, and put it back up. But when you split, all your logs fall on the ground, so you have to take it out. And again, now it's a smaller piece, now it's even harder to get it steady. And again, you see it kind of slid through and only a tip got stuck into this wood. Sometimes what happens, you hit it, you chop it aside and then it keeps going and between your legs, so you gotta watch out from your legs. When you split wood like this, you don't have to worry about it's falling over, it just resting on it really well. And when you hit it here, it will split all the way through really easily. And also if you miss it, it will stop it here or stop it here, or when you go through all the way, it just will stop on this piece of log. So let's see what I'm talking about. When I'm gonna hit it right here, boom, it split through, it stay in one spot, so I grab it, throw it away. And also the arc stopped, I don't have to catch it, so I save a lot of energy, and also it's much safer, I'm not gonna chop my leg off. So this is like a safety. So let's see this from this angle. I wanna hit it right here. Just like that. And to pull it out, just go like this, boom. You see it's pretty thick piece of wood, so I'm gonna flip it around, but you see it's cracked all the way almost. Now I'm gonna hit it from this side. Look, it's cracked almost all the way. So just gotta do one more hit and it's done. Boom, pretty awesome, huh? Now I'm gonna grab this piece of wood and put it this way and just hit it right here again. Easy. Now this one. One more time. And you see? And you see it split it in half again. Got my axe. I wanna hit right here. Boom. Look at this. One hit and I split it. Two hits. Boom. And if it didn't go all the way through, you can just flip it around. Missed it. Done. So with practice, it's just gonna get easier and easier. So this is the easiest way to split wood with an axe like this. You see, sharp axe. Well guys, be careful chopping wood and let me know how do you chop wood in comments below. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.